In this chapter, we'll talk about estimating cost, and we'll also look at problem 10-20. Let's look at some conceptual aspects of estimating cost. In order to use cost behavior in accounting, we have to estimate and come up with a total cost function. We know that total cost equals our variable cost per unit plus total fixed cost. You may recall in your math class that it was also expressed as y equals mx plus b. In the textbook, sometimes in this chapter, the author represents it as y equals a plus bx. We'll primarily focus on the accounting format, which is the total cost equals the variable cost per unit plus total fixed cost. The variable cost per unit is our slope of the line. The fixed cost in total is the y-intercept. In other words, where the line crosses the y-axis. Slope is the steepness of the line. The x will be an activity, and we're going to refer to this as an independent variable. If we change that number, the total cost will change. So total cost is considered to be a dependent variable. Sometimes we refer to total cost as the y variable. We have three assumptions when we're dealing with cost behavior. Number one, we assume that within a relevant range, costs behave as we expect them to behave. In other words, fixed cost in total remain the same, and variable cost per unit remain the same. The relevant range is a normal operating range of activity, just whatever number of units our company is comfortable in handling. It might be between 10,000 and 12,000 units of activity. We'll also make an assumption that only one variable will explain the change in the cost. This is usually sufficient for estimating cost behavior in the future in accounting. We'll also make an assumption about time, that on a short time basis, whether it be less than 1 year or 1 year, that we can expect the cost to stay the same behavior as what we initially estimate. If we were to look at a long period of time, say 10 years, then our assumption of how costs behave will likely change. There are three cost behaviors: variable, fixed, and then a combination of those called mixed cost, sometimes referred to as semi-variable cost. What we're going to look at mostly in this chapter is how to estimate cost behavior. Estimate just means come up with a cost function based on a good approximation of how we think a particular cost will behave in the future. You learned two or three different methods to do this in managerial accounting. We're going to look at the names of two additional methods, but not worry about how we go about using these. The industrial engineering method, sometimes just referred to as engineering method, is very tedious, but it's very thorough. We use engineering formulas to analyze the relationships between inputs and outputs, and we base the outcome on physical terms. The conference method, we meet with lots of people within our company, and we get opinions of different departments of how should these costs be labeled. It's really quick, but it's not very accurate because opinions are subject to being not as accurate as we would like them to be. We're going to look very closely at account analysis again, scatter graphs, high-low method, and linear regression. Pretty much the first three of these are methods that you looked at in managerial accounting, likely the last one as well, but we're going to look at linear regression in a little bit more depth. Account analysis is a method to estimate cost behavior, to come up with a cost function, and it involves us looking at a cost, deciding is it fixed, variable, or mixed based on the activity, and then we come up with the cost function. It's highly judgmental, but if it's done by accountants who are familiar with the nature of the cost, then it can be reasonably accurate. A scatter graph depends on the accuracy of drawing a graph. It identifies observations, and sometimes we can see the observations that are extreme, those that might not fall strictly in the pattern that we would like them to fall in. But it's really hard to estimate this accurately because of the inaccuracy of drawing a graph and picking out the points and plotting them on the graph. The high-low method is one of the quantitative methods. It's relatively easy to complete. Its drawbacks, it uses only two data points, the high activity level and the low activity level. And these can often be extremes that may not be an indicator of the rest of the data. Linear regression uses all the data points, so it typically is the best method. And it looks at the average change in the dependent variables as it relates to a change in the independent variables. We're going to begin with problem 1020. This problem, we're going to work with the account analysis method. We see a list of account names along with related cost. And we're going to go through each of these and thinking about them in context of a car wash, how should these costs be categorized? Labor in accounting generally means hourly amounts. And if we look at the number of car washes as our activity, as the number of car washes increases, the cost of car wash labor should increase. So we're going to put the $260,000 in the variable cost column. Soap, cloth, and supplies, that cost should go up in total when we have more car washes. So that as well is variable. Water. Not all companies can view water as being variable, but in a car wash, the more cars you wash, the more water you use, so the cost of water will increase. This will also be a variable cost for the car wash. Electric power to move the conveyor belt. If you've been to one of the automated car washes, when you drive through, they take a clamp and attach your tire to the conveyor, and that will pull your car through the washing system. The more cars we pull through the washing system, the higher the cost of electric power. So this cost is most likely variable. Depreciation, we know, is always considered fixed because it stays the same in total even if we wash a different number of cars. So I'm going to put the cost of depreciation here in the fixed column. Salaries, by definition, mean a person who earns a salary gets paid the same amount no matter how many hours worked. Our manager here will get paid the same salary no matter how many cars move through the system. So we're going to classify salaries of $46,000 as fixed. We then total up the cost in each of these categories. We then want to put them into the total cost equation format. Total cost equals variable cost per unit times number of units plus total fixed cost. Fixed cost and total are in the right format. Variable cost, we will need to convert those to a cost per unit. These costs listed in the problem were based on 80,000 cars washed during 2012. So if we divide the 80,000 into the 412,000, we come up with a unit variable cost of $5.15 per car. We can now put this into the cost equation. 515 times number of cars plus 110,000. Part 2 says how much will our cost be if we wash 90,000 cars. So we want to plug in 90,000 for X. X being the variable number of cars. And when we solve for total cost, we come up to $573,500. This concludes this part of the video. We will look at regression and high-low method in the next video.